Welcome to the videos on the IEC 61850 standard and Ingeteam INGESYS eFS tool. The purpose of these videos is to give you a quick detailed guide, without being an expert, to the IEC 61850 standard and to see how it is applied to INGESYS eFS. The video is aimed at those who may or may not have knowledge of the standard but who do not know the tool. By following the steps that we'll give you in these videos, anyone who is unfamiliar with the standard or the tool will be able to set up IEC 61850 communication with any device which is compatible with the standard. They will be able to integrate the device in the tool as well as in the INGESYS ITO PC server and in the SCADA's other modules. There are other videos to help you integrate the IEC 61850 devices in INGESYS IC3's UCSRTU. As soon as you install INGESYS eFS, the first thing to start up is this toolbar. The bar is divided into three parts. The first part is a news channel related to the IEC 61850 standard. The second part provides direct access to the tool's applications. In the third part, there is an alert window as well as information on the license, the user, the installed version, the device's name, the active language, the firewall status, etc. There is no project activated yet, but if there were, the project's name would also appear. INGESYS IT and INGESYS eFS are project-based, and the tool for managing these projects is called Project Factory. To launch it, you can click on the Project Factory button or on the bar which shows the name of the active project. You can organize each of the plants that you want to model with the tool as a project so that each project has its own separate configuration. In order to work with a project, you need to activate it, which is equivalent to opening a project. Project Factory lets you create, delete and activate projects as well as add a description, make a backup copy, etc. In this video, we'll create a new project to show how to make a configuration from scratch. So by following these videos you will learn all the steps from creating a project to establishing communication with a device. To create a new project, click on the new button. INGESYS IT and INGESYS eFS have a user management system whereby each user has a level with higher or lower permission settings. The tool provides a default user. If this is not changed, the user will be manager and the password will be ITSA. When you click on the Show Password checkbox, you will see the password entered. However, we recommend that you create new users and passwords. When you create a new project, the tool suggests the first project name available. You can change this name to one of your choice. Once the project has been created, eFS Project 2 in this case, you need to activate it in order to work with it. To do this, click on the activation button. After activating the project, the bar will change its appearance. Since there was no active project, only the Project Factory, Operation Factory, Emulation Factory and Pack Factory buttons were enabled. These programs do not necessarily depend on an active project to work. They can work with as being linked to an active project or as a series of XML files for the IEC 61850 standard. When the project is activated, it looks like the one on the screen, with all of the tools available in the computer. On this PC, both INGESYS IT and INGESYS eFS have been installed. INGESYS IT is the Ingeteam SCADA system, INGESYS eFS is the Ingeteam tool aimed at the IEC 61850 standard. When you have installed the two tools and have licenses for the various modules, all of the tools on the button bar will be enabled. If any button is disabled, it may be that a module has not been installed or that there is no valid license. Once the project has been created and activated, the two tools that we are going to work with most are IED Factory and Substation Factory. IED Factory is a tool which lets you create all of the library of the devices that you're going to use in the project. It lets you import the device models of any IEC 61850 compliant manufacturer, create IEC 61850 devices from scratch, or create devices based on other protocols. Let's start to work with the IED Factory tool to create devices in the device library. Once we have created devices, we can register them in Substation Factory. Substation Factory is the tool with which the substation is really modeled. Over the course of these videos, you will see the difference between these two engineering tools. Starting with the devices library, the tree at the right of IED Factory shows the devices present in the devices library of the current project. When it starts up, two default devices are loaded with the names of the IEC 61850 and IEC 61400-25 standard. Although they are created automatically, these two devices are empty for now. The reason why they are empty is because the creation of the standard itself takes time and space on disk, so it has been left for the user to do manually. We recommend that you import the standard since it may be helpful as a reference tool. To do this, there is an option for importing templates in the tools menu. The imported template provides the IEC 61850 and IEC 61400-25 standards. Besides these protocols, there are other templates needed to model communication using other protocols. To start, you simply need to import the IEC 61850 standard. It is used to define the different types of classes, data, etc. related to the substation. There is a model for switches, choppers, protection functions, inputs and outputs, etc. There are other types of classes for everything related to distributed renewable energies, wind power, etc. In the case of wind power, the IEC 61400-25 standard contains everything related to the different wind turbine elements, modeling elements such as the yaw, pitch, rotor, met mast, GPS, etc. Wind turbines that comply with the IEC 61400-25 standard will be easy to integrate into the tool. To start, choose the IEC 61850 standard. When you select it, the tool will ask whether you want to overwrite the standard that was in the project, deleting the previous one. In this step, the different types of information are imported, from the lower level such as data attribute to more complex information models such as common data class, ending with high-level functions or logical nodes. At the end, a dialog box will be shown indicating the result of the import process. There have been no errors or warning messages. There are only informative messages indicating that the process has finished correctly. In the devices library tree, the standard's different levels of content and you can open them to browse through them. To do this, you can click and drag from the devices window on the right-hand side to the current device, or tree on the left. You can also use the open option. When you do this, all of the devices available in the devices library are shown. Each device has an information hierarchy, in other words, the information model that it is going to use, as well as a set of classes and subclasses on which it is based. In the case of the standard, the hierarchical model is empty given that it is not a real device and for the moment, we only have the classes available to make its model. These classes are divided into logical node, data object and data attribute. There is a large amount of information distributed into different levels which will be gradually analyzed. However, these videos do not show all of the levels. What is important is that the standard itself helps facilitate all of this information and serves as a guide. The following videos will explain the concepts of the logical node, data object, data attribute, hierarchical model, etc. The IEC 61850 standard has two main objectives. The first is to provide interoperability between manufacturers. The second objective is to reduce engineering times. These days, there are many communications protocols and many of them are standard. The aim of facilitating interoperability is common to all of them, but the IEC 61850 standard has provided an added value in that the information models are textual. This means that by analyzing the information model exchanged between two devices, someone who knows the standard without necessarily knowing these devices is able to interpret what the information means. The data does not consist of indices in memory maps but instead textual names that express the information to be represented. Furthermore and highly helpful during the configuration of communications, every IEC 61850 device is associated to an XML tool containing its information model and its capacity and communication behavior towards the client. Hence, the classic communications profiles indispensable in other communication protocols are designed and expressed in IEC 61850 in the configuration XML of the device itself. The XML that accompanies the device or which is generated for the device using an engineering tool can be imported by the communications client device. Hence, using minimal manual intervention, the two devices, client and server, are configured. Consequently, the client knows the server's capability perfectly, and with very little effort, higher-level communications are obtained with excellent performance and great flexibility for the profiles or usual practices of electrical companies.
Thank you.